Hello, my name is Theodore Cobos. The artist that I chose to focus on and do my visual analysis was John M. Valdez, and it's two pieces, Alice y Clavo. I saw them at the El Paso Museum of Art during Chicano art exhibit, displaying Cheech Marin's collection of Chicano art. The two pieces stand at a dimension of 23 and a half inches by 15 and a half inches. First piece of artwork that I'm going to look at is Clavo by John M. Valdez. 2014, done in serigraph, which is a form of silk printing. Right away, we get an image of a young Chicano youth, fairly young, about maybe mid to late teens. His attire is what some would deem typical of Chicano youth and living in East Los Angeles at the time. His pants are oversized, his waist slim. His shirt is a common underdress shirt. Right away, one can make the connotations that this young man is from very humble origin or background. Upon a closer inspection, one can see that there is evidence of stylistic-wise pointillism. Different shades, different colors, all distinctly separate. The closer you examine the painting, each its own individual point of color. It's creating an optical illusion of different shades of color just by the distance and or proximity of different individual points of color. Next, we have Alice by the same artist, John Valdez, 2014, also done in serigraph. And right away we get the same image, kind of like the male-female version of Clavo. She's wearing also oversized Dickies pants and a meager white tube top covering herself. She is striking a slightly different pose than Clavo is. She has one hand up and kind of fixing her hair. She's about the same age as Clavo, so one can imply that perhaps they were a romantic or a couple during the time of the actual photographs were taken. The same thing also, you can also imply that socioeconomic circumstances have not been favorable to her situation. My overall summary or analysis of the painting is that he's depicting two Chicano youths living on the fringes of society. To some, they may appear threatening, menacing because of their unfamiliarity. However, once they're stripped of their social connotations, one begins to observe two fragile young children forced to grow up way too soon and create this facade of toughness, but they stand defiantly proud and erect with a sense of majestic elegance. His message basically is to Chicanos and Chicanas this equally that that you're beautiful and you're worthy of being the subject of great art. The process that he undertakes also quite telling for me, at least. The pointillism and the screen printing both create bright, intense colors as an optical illusion because of their proximity to one another. Each point or dot is actually its own intense, vibrant color. And even in the white spaces that appear to be white spaces where there's nothing there, there stands lone, solitary dots of points of color that, up close, they're as intense as any other point in the painting. But because they're out there and isolated doesn't mean they're not important to the fabric of America.